Welcome out to Jefferson County Stadium for the Juke Thursday Night Throwdown as number 7 Chatfield collides with number 5 Bear Creek. Abby Wehner, Chris Lewis along with you as this the biggest game, no doubt, for these teams all year long. Now, if 3 yards and a cloud of dust is what you're looking for in your football game, this one not for you, Abby.
Well, Chris, this game definitely passing versus passing game, which in turn it really puts a lot of pressure on the defense. Tonight, I think it's going to be really interesting to see which team is able to put more pressure on the quarterback, perhaps taking some of that pressure off their secondary.
Being at practices all week and talking to the coaches here before the game, we know that defense is what these guys, everybody out there wants to talk about, the aerial attack, but these coaches know it's going to be won defensively. And also they tell us that the big play is the key. Can their team come up with the big play when it's needed?
Well, like Chris, the passing game and the running game, they are not mutually exclusive. I think tonight we're probably going to see a little bit more of a balance than we've seen in games past with either of these teams.
Two great quarterbacks manning these teams. Let's head down to the field to check out the first half action. And as anticipated, Abby, first quarter, both these teams not afraid to go 3, 4, even sometimes 5 wide.
Well, when you spread the field for the passing game, in turn it also spreads the defense, which opens up the running game. Like we mentioned, something that both of the coaches said to us before the game they were going to be looking for.
Bear Creek, a great opening drive after a key fourth down defensive stop. The Chatfield D just takes all the momentum right from the Bear Creek offense and hands it to Sam Stratton and the Chatfield offense.
Well, exactly like you said, Chris. Standing here on the sidelines, we saw a significant momentum shift as the defense came off the field, clearly handing that off to the offense and Sam Stratton.
And with a minute left in the opening frame, it was Sam who scampers in for the TD. 7-0 now Chatfield. Bear Creek, though, with a great response. They march down with a methodical drive themselves, marching 66 yards. Lucas Lockett then puts the cherry on the top of this one.
Well, Felton here, nothing fancy, but he was really just directing the offense, kept his composure, showed the kind of leadership that you really like to see out of your quarterback.
7-7, our score midway through the second quarter. All of a sudden, the Chargers just able to hit that gas pedal, lock down defensively, and then make big offensive play after big offensive play. And then the defense stepped it up, not once, but twice inside the Bear Creek red zone, locking them down, not allowing them to score, and we go to the half, 21-7. The second half highlights now, Abby, and big plays, you want them, we got them. This a 70-yard run. Stratton busting it wide open to open up the second half.
Well, that's the momentum from the first half, that play that he had on with a great touchdown pass. Clearly, he came out of the locker room, still fired up to make a great play to open up the second half.
Stratton, Wyoming bound, I think he could have run that one all the way to Laramie. Bear Creek, though, Abby, they got a playmaker of their own. This guy wearing number 23 tonight.
Lucas Lockett, between his speed and strength, he was clearly the workhorse for Bear Creek all night long.
Bear Creek known as an air attack team, but Lockett proves they can do it on the ground too. Chatfield then finds a score of their own, and you think this one's going to be all Chargers all night. But somehow, Bear Creek finds himself ready to score, down 2 scores, a big pass interference call that the Chargers fans didn't agree with, to say the least, and Bear Creek able to capitalize.
Well, that offense, I think, was coming from the energy that the defense on Bear Creek really picked up. They got a stop on fourth down. You could really see the energy picking up on the sidelines, in the stands, and clearly on the field. Final score, Chatfield 34, Bear Creek 21, and now back to Chris with the guy who did it all tonight, our player of the game.
I tell you what, Sam, a huge win for you guys, and I think a lot of people around Colorado are going to take notice that Chatfield's the real deal.
Yeah, you know, every week it's just been the same thing, find a way to win, and tonight was no different. We had a great crowd out at homecoming, and it was a lot of fun, and we found a way to win.
Hey, not much time for breathing room. You've got Columbine coming up next week already.
Yeah, you know, they're a great team as well, and, you know, we got to get ready tomorrow. We're going to watch film on them, and, you know, we're going to enjoy it tonight, but we're going to go back to work tomorrow.
This is Sam Stratton. Big winners for Chatfield tonight. Chris Lewis at Juke's Game of the Week, Fox 31 Sports.